Hi, this is Kian once again. Welcome to Prayer Line. Precious one, I want you to know that today is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Today I have a simple message for you. How do you overcome your fears? How do we overcome our fears? And the word of God to you today is that overcome your fears. I should overcome my fears with faith in our Lord Jesus, faith in God. How do I overcome my fears in life? And as a believer, we are admonished that we should have faith, and faith will come driving out all fears. There is a saying that when fears, when panic, when stress, when worry, when depression and anxiety comes knocking at the door of your life and causing you to go through all the emotional turmoil, just release faith. Just ask faith to go and answer the door to fear. Fear is coming at your life, knocking at your door, knocking. Fear, that is fear. A worrisome problem is coming, knocking at your door. Just tell faith in our Lord Jesus Christ to go and answer the door. And you realize that when fear meets faith, fear will turn back and run away. Simple illustration, but very powerful. We have to learn to overcome our fears with faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. Simple. Whenever you are afraid, just put your trust in our Lord Jesus. When you put your trust in Jesus, He will give you perfect peace, because He is the Prince of Peace. Now, whenever you are afraid, worrisome, stressed out, depressed, worrying, and doubting, and you don't know what to do with your life, ask yourself this question: what would Jesus do if He was in my situation? What did Jesus do when He was in my situation? Precious one, I want you to know that we are serving a God who has one time become like man and has been through what you and I are going through when He was on the face of the earth. That's why Jesus is very sensitive, very, very sensitive to your experiences and my experiences, because He is an attorney. He is a God who has firsthand experienced what you and I are going through. So He has not only empathy and sympathy, He has both empathy and sympathy for you and I, because He's been through what we are going through. He's been in your shoes before, and He has been in my shoes before. So He is very sensitive, very compassionate, moved with pity when He sees us going through fears. So anytime you're going through fear, ask yourself, what would Jesus have done differently, or what did He do? And immediately that you ask yourself that question, you will know that the Prince of Peace will give you always a very good answer. Because when Jesus Christ was on earth, anytime He was confronted with a fearful, fearsome, worrisome, depressing, stressful, situation, He was always cool, calm, and collected. Cool, calm and collected. And that's what he will also give to you. He will help you to be cool, calm, and collected. He will always give you peace. Peace in the midst of your crisis or problem. Because the Holy Spirit is always cool, calm, and collected. And so whenever you are afraid and you put your trust in God, in Jesus, he will only give you peace by helping you to become cool, calm, and collected in the face of a situation, because that's how he operated when he was on earth. He was never moved because he was always trusting in God, the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit, as I told you, is always cool, calm, and collected. God is never moved by our situations, our problems, our needs, the things that shake us. Let me give you an example of how Jesus Christ responded to a fearful situation. One time, the Bible says that Jesus and his disciples were on the face of the water traveling, and there was a boisterous wind which was turning him and his disciples left and right. They were almost going to be drowned by the kind of boisterous situation that was going on, because the wind, the Bible says, the wind was contrary, being in the middle of the sea, and now the winds and the storms are just raging and tossing them left and right. Remember, Jesus Christ, his disciples like Peter, James, and John, these were experts in fishing, so they have been sailing for a long time, so they knew what to do. But at that moment, they did not have power. They could not control the situation. They knew they were going to die. When fishermen come to a place and they know they are going to die, it means that the situation was very terrifying. It was very troubling. It was very, very, very difficult situation. And so, at the time when the disciples did not know what to do and they were afraid of their life, these fishermen who were expert in fishing gave up in their own abilities to control or have solutions to the situation. They rather turned to Jesus. Do you know, let me tell you, during all this time that went, during all the time that the disciples were troubled, Jesus Christ was cool, calm, and collected. He was busy sleeping. No, the problem which was moving and shaking and causing worrying and anxiety and fear and nervous breakdown and depression, and the disciples didn't know what to do. They were hopeless and they were almost giving up. They thought they had come to the rope of their life, as some of you listening to the sound of my voice right now are feeling and are going through. I want you to know that Jesus was never moved by those storms. There is a storm you are going through right now. There's a financial storm. There's a storm about you hearing the bad news from the doctor. There's a storm about you. You went for an interview and they did not hire you. There's a storm about a storm going on in your marriage, a storm with you and your kids. There's a storm that has arisen at your workplace. There's a storm you have lost a job. There's a storm that you are going through right now. But I want you to know that turn to Jesus, because he has the solutions. He is always cool, calm, and collected. If you will trust him today, you also have the same peace in your life. Cool, calm, collected, not moved, because he knows the end from the end from the beginning, and he has solutions already ready for you. Jesus Christ, as I was telling you, was in the same boat with his disciples. The disciples were shaking, tossed left and right, but Jesus was cool, calm, and collected, and he was busy sleeping. And then when the disciples began to now not trust in their expertise or trust in their wisdom and their ability, but trust in Jesus, they woke Jesus Christ's eyes up and told him, "Lord, don't you care, lest we perish." Jesus Christ just rose up, smiled, and said, "Hey, peace, be still. Peace, be still." And immediately the storm, the raging storm that was tossing the disciples left and right, the raging storms that was almost going to drown the disciples, immediately the storm stilled. Everything calmed down, because for once the disciples learned to confront their fears with faith in Jesus. And always, as I told you, Jesus is always cool, calm, and collected. The Prince of Peace just rose up and just calm the storms, give answers, give solutions to the complications that they were going through. Cool, calm, and collected. what you are going through, what I'm going through, never moves the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit is all-powerful God. There's nothing too hard for the Holy Spirit. There's nothing too hard for Jesus. There's nothing too hard for God. What you are going through, it is a piece of cake to God. If only you and I will trust God, cast your burdens onto me, for I care for you. The Bible says that, he will give perfect peace to those whose mind stays on him. The reason why you are afraid, your reason why you are nervous, the reason why you are stressing, the reason why you are so afraid, terrified, and you are so feeling hopeless and feeling down and don't know what to do with you. Some of us, when we are so afraid, we don't even eat anymore. We can't eat, and it is having a toll on your body. Look at you. Look at you. Some of us too, when we are so afraid, we eat. Just eat and eat and eat. Some of us, when we are afraid, we shut people away from us. Some of us, when we are afraid, we talk to everybody on the phone, complaining to people about our problems, except the only one whom we ought to talk to, Jesus Christ. You are talking to the wrong people about your problem. Man cannot help you. Man cannot help you. Cursed is anyone who puts his trust in man. I tell you, man will disappoint you. Man cannot bail you out. Man cannot bail you out. So learn today. God is telling me to tell you to trust him than trusting in man. Man cannot help you. Your husband cannot help you. Your pastor cannot help you. Your friends cannot help you. Only Jesus. When you are confronted with fear, afraid of the situation, overcome the fear with faith, not in your wisdom, not in your expertise, not in your experience, not in your decrees, not in people, but faith in our Lord Jesus. And faith in our Lord Jesus, faith in the Holy Spirit will help you to always have peace, because the Holy Spirit, Jesus, is always cool, calm, and collected. There was also one incident. Let me tell you this thing. The one time Jesus Christ was confronted with this situation, he had financial insufficiency. He had nothing. He had no money. And yet still, he needed to feed almost, the Bible says, the 5,000 men. But according to the statistics, during that revival, they had almost 20,000 people there listening to him. No. If men were 5,000, women would be 10,000, including children. So you round them up. We are talking about almost 20,000 people. I had come into God, Jesus Christ's revival, trying to listen to him, and they were hungry. Now Jesus Christ is faced with a situation of having to feed almost 20,000 people. With what? No money. With what? No food. If it was you, if it was me, we don't have money. We have bills to pay. We don't have money. We have to settle the rent. We have to pay the mortgage company. We have to pay the bills, the light bills and the phone bills and the electricity bills. Or we have to take care of our children. We have to pay the bills for the car notes and the mortgage company and all those things. And there's no money. Some of us will be going crazy. Some of us will be so afraid, panicking, worrying. And you've lost a job too. Come on. You have lost a job and you need to pay your creditors, and they are coming after you, calling you constantly on the phone, and you are losing your mind. The reason why sometimes we are losing our minds is because we are not operating like Jesus. Let me tell you how Jesus operated. Jesus has to feed 20,000 people. No food, no money. What did he do? He wasn't afraid. He was cool, calm, and collected, because he knew the Holy Spirit was with him, and he knew God was going to always bail him out. Today I'm talking about somebody that God wants to bail you out. Politicians are always bailing themselves out. The European nations are trying to bail themselves about who will bail you out when you are in your deepest fear. Who will bail you out when you are in your financial stress? Who will bail you out when you are sick and the doctors have given up on you and you are going down? Who will bail you out when your marriage is breaking and things are falling apart in the family? Who will bail you out when you have been looking for jobs and nobody, you are not making a headway and you have bills to pay? Who will bail you out? Can the government bail you out? Can Obama bail you out? Can the Republican bail you out? Don't be deceived. Your politicians cannot help you. Jesus tells me he will bail you out. if only you will confront your fear with faith in our Lord Jesus. Today I'm talking expressly about having faith in our Lord Jesus Christ and relying on His power, His ability to change situations and to give you victory over every fear, over every depression, over every anxiety, over every worrisome, every depressive, over every challenge that you are going through. I don't know who I'm speaking to, but you are deep in depression, deep in worry, deep in anxiety, deep in fear, nervous breakdown. You are stressing too much and God wants to build you out. God wants to relieve you. God wants to help you. But you need to trust Him by asking yourself, how would Jesus deal with this situation I'm going through? And that's what I'm telling you. Jesus would have been cool, calm, and collected. And Him being the Prince of Peace would have had peace in that situation and would have trusted in the Most High to help him. So today, trust in Jesus and allow Him to step in and build you out and change the situation. Now, Jesus Christ, I'm going back to the story, is confronted to meeting the needs of 20,000 people. No money and also no food. However, He was cool, calm, and collected. Now, Jesus Christ, all they had, the disciples had, was five loaves of bread and two fishes. They brought it. They brought the five fish and the two loaves of bread to Jesus Christ. And He just thanked God. And do you know what happened? It multiplied. And it was able to feed the almost 20,000 people crowd. And there was a leftover of 12 baskets. Jesus, when He was confronted with the fearful, worrisome situation of insufficiency, poverty, having to settle those bills and having to meet the needs, and yet they had nothing, He was cool, calm, and collected, trusted in His Heavenly Father, prayed, and God answered His prayer, and God multiplied. I'm speaking to somebody who is going through financial insufficiency, going through poverty. You don't have money. You don't even have a job. And yes, you have bills to pay. You have things to take care of. I pray in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ that today, if you will trust God, if you will confront your fear with faith in our Lord Jesus, He will also make a way for you. He will multiply your finances. He will come through. He will give you favor with your creditors to the extent that they will relieve you of the phone calls and off, they will cut half of your bills and you will come through. Have faith in God. With Him, all things are possible. Jesus Christ was cool, calm, and collected. That's what you have to have, because the word you are putting your trust in knows the end from the beginning, and He always has solutions. Solutions to every problem. Solutions to marital problem. Solutions to financial problem. Solutions to health problem. Solutions to economic problem. And whatever situation that you have, I tell you the truth, Jesus Christ is cool, calm, and collected, and peaceful, because He has solutions. Don't be moved. Don't be moved. Don't be moved by what you are going through. Don't be moved by what you are hearing. Trust in our Lord Jesus Christ. Confront your fears with faith. And faith in Jesus Christ will build you out and save the day for you. And you don't have to worry anymore. You don't. Ask yourself, how would Jesus Christ deal with this situation? And if Jesus Christ has been through this before, then I bet you He will help you out. He will come out. So if He is going to help you, why they need to worry? The Bible says that why do we worry about tomorrow? For tomorrow will take care of itself. Even the birds, they do not worry about how to sow and what to reap, because their Heavenly Father takes care of even the birds. The Bible says that even the hair on your head are numbered. Numbering is different from counting, meaning that each and every one of the details of your hair is known by God. How much more your God, your Heavenly Father, doesn't know that He has to take care of your bills, take care of your family, take care of your children, take care of your finances, take care of your marriage, take care of your health. God is interested in you. What makes you think that He has abandoned you, He has forsaken you, He has rejected you, He doesn't care about you, whether you die, whether you live, whether how you eat, and God cares about all these things. So please, trust God. Depend on Him. Rely on Him by saying, Lord, You know better than I do, so I let go. I give all to You. I surrender my problems to You. I surrender all. I surrender all to You. I surrender all to You. Take control. No. There was also one incident Let me tell you this story. There's one incident when Jesus Christ was confronted with a hopeless, disastrous situation about the death of his friend Lazarus. The Bible makes us to understand that Jesus Christ was with his disciples, and a news, a telegram, an email, a text, a Twitter, a mail came through that, hey, Jesus, please, we need you to come quickly, for your own friend Lazarus is at the point of dying. They sent somebody to come and tell Jesus ahead of time. They tweeted him, they emailed him, they faxed him, they sent him a message through the Facebook, and Jesus Christ got a message all right. But yes, he was cool. I like this about Jesus. I like this about the Holy Spirit. Jesus Christ was cool, calm, and collected. He wasn't moved by the situation that his own friend Lazarus was dying. The Bible says that he even delayed, knowing very well that if I delay, this guy would die. He was cool, calm, and collected. He wasn't even afraid in the face of death. So I want you to know, don't be afraid in the face of the bad report of the doctors. The truth of the matter is that the doctors, as much as they are experts in the field of health, they are not God. Your doctor is not God, the nurses are not gods, and they don't have power to really heal anybody. Whatever they are doing is to help us to recuperate, or to for the body to heal itself by helping, put things in place for the body to heal. No doctor is God. No doctor can add to your life or subtract. So your doctors are not God, so they don't have the last word in your health, the last word in your life. Put your trust in God, the great physician, the one who created you, is the same God who can also extend your life, can heal you from every disease and every sickness. Right now, I'm prophesying to somebody who has heard a bad report from the doctors. I declare to you that whatever the doctors have said, I negate it even in Jesus' name. You will not die. You will live and declare the works of the Lord. I speak healing. I speak health into your body in Jesus' name. So the Bible says that a news came through text, through Twitter, through email, through fax, through the mail, that hey, your own friend Lazarus is dying. Sometimes our Lazarus dies. Sometimes, even though you are a Christian, sometimes bad things could still happen to you. Even though you are trusting in God, bad things can still happen to you, and you wonder, where is God? Where is Jesus? I thought he was my friend. I thought he would have come through. I want you to know that Jesus is cool, calm, and collected. The Holy Spirit is cool, calm, and collected. God is cool, calm, and collected about your death issue, because he knows that he is the resurrection and the life. And when he comes through, even that which is dead will come back to life. So the Bible says that Jesus was cool, calm, and collected. When he came to the scene, Martha was crying, "Oh Jesus, oh Jesus," like most of us are doing. "Oh, if Jesus had only come through early, if Jesus had only heard my prayer early, if Jesus has only come through sooner." I want to tell you the truth. Jesus is never too early, and he's never too late. He always comes through at the right time. He never makes any mistakes about the situation that you've been through. Maybe you have had a loss, but he's still in control. Maybe you are going through a death or a painful bad report from the doctors. God knows what he's doing. If you are a child of God, I came to prophesy to you. I came to announce to you that all things, whether good, bad, ugly, are all working together for your good, because God is in his throne and he knows exactly what he's doing. God is wiser than you and I. Many times we think we are wiser than God. Why wouldn't God, when Herod was trying to kill Jesus, why didn't he just give Herod a heart attack? But in his wisdom, he allowed Herod to live, and he had other alternative way of delivering his child Jesus by sending him to Egypt. If it was you and I, we would have just given Herod heart attack, and that would have saved the day. But God does not operate like you and I operate. When God was going to allow his son Jesus to be born, if it is you and I, we would have looked for the best palace, best hotel, best place to put him. But he allowed his own son to be born in a manger. Would you have done that? Would I have done that? No. Because our wisdom is different from God's wisdom. In fact, God's foolishness can be compared to our wisdom. You can't compare your wisdom to God's wisdom, because the foolishness of God is man's wisdom. So we can only equate our wisdom with God's foolishness. That's how far we can go, because God is too wise for us to even compare ourselves to Him. God knows what He's doing in your life. God knows what He's doing in my life. He's always cool, calm, and collected in the face of any situation. That's why you ought to learn to operate that way, by learning to overcome your fear with faith in our Lord Jesus Christ and turning the battles to Him, for Him to fight on your behalf to win the day for you. Stop worrying. Stop causing, allowing depression and worrying and stress and nervous breakdown to take a hold on your life. Look at you. Just look at the mirror. Just look at you. Just look at you. You are looking miserable. Put some smiles on your face. Let the joy of the Lord be your strength. Let the peace of God that surpasses all understanding keep your heart and mind. Please, snap out of that fearful and worrisome and depressing and anxious lifestyle. Come on, be happy. Let the joy of the Lord be your strength. Let the peace of God that surpasses all understanding begin to manifest in your life. Let happiness begin to bubble in your life, because God has not given us the spirit of fear, but sound mind and boldness. Please, God is speaking to you. Rely on Him, depend on Him, and let your faith in Jesus repel and dissolve every fear in your life. I came to tell you that God is rolling away every reproach, every shame, every mountain, every valley situation you are going through, everything that is confronting you. God is going to confront that situation. Just learn to trust Him. Just learn to trust Him. So as I'm going back to the story, Jesus Christ comes. Martha says that, Lord, if you had come early, this situation would have not arisen, because we test you, we emailed you, we faxed you, we did everything to get you aware on time, and yes, you were just cool, calm, and collected. You were responding as though nothing was happening. Now he's dead. What are you going to do about it? Now it is too late. What are you going to do about it? You are telling God that, what is He going to do about your situation? Maybe you've lost the job. Maybe you have lost the home. Maybe the marriage has broken. Maybe situation looks hopeless. But with God, nothing is too hopeless. With God, He can reverse the irreversible, change the unchangeable, and do the impossible. I came to announce to you that God is about to do a miraculous act in your life. There's going to be a sign and a wonder in your life. Just have faith in Jesus. Just have faith in Jesus, and He will give you a miracle. There's a miracle coming through for somebody right now, even the name of our Lord Jesus. Even in the name of our Lord Jesus, I see God removing some mountains. I see God bringing down the walls of Jericho. I see God parting the Red Sea before you into two. I see God supernaturally touching the heart of people to begin to do you good. I see God giving you favor with your creditors. I see God miraculously coming through in your marriage and saving the day for you and your husband, restoring peace, restoring understanding, restoring love, restoring agreement, restoring peace, restoring joy in that marriage. I see God touching somebody right now with healing and deliverance. I see God rebuking your enemies on your behalf and delivering you from the strong man, from the stronghold, from demons and witches and wizards. I see God right now breaking curses from somebody's life, even in Jesus' name. I see yokes being broken as God bringing deliverance to the body of Christ right now. Receive your deliverance. Receive your healing. Receive your breakthrough. Receive your miracle. Financial miracle is coming through. Somebody, they have rejected your application for so long, but God is coming through. You are going to hear a good report from this, the recent interview where God is giving you favor. They are going to call you and grant you that job, even in Jesus' name. God is working right now. Believe, cast your burdens onto Him, for He cares for you. Trust in Him and He will come through for you. Call upon Him and He will answer you and show you great and mighty things. Ask and it shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door shall be open. Begin to open your mouth and say, Lord, come through for me. God, help me. God, help me. I'm afraid. Help me. And He will come through for you. We are the children of God, and God cares about us. God is doing great and awesome things right now. I sense God doing a great thing in the lives of the body of Christ. So Jesus Christ comes. Martha says that you are too late. And immediately Jesus says that I am the resurrection and I am the life. Anyone who believes in me will not die. And those who even die, they will rise up again. And Mary, Martha says that, Lord, if you had come, it is too early. Jesus Christ goes to the tomb and He says that roll away the stone. Roll away your doubt. Roll away your unbelief. Roll away your skepticism and begin to have faith in God. And Jesus Christ called out, Lazarus, come forth. And he who was dead came back to life. Today, every situation which seems hopeless, which seems impossible, which seems irreversible, which has come to the dead end, is coming back if only you have faith in Jesus. He is the resurrection and the life. Today, God has sent me to tell you that turn to Him, rely on Him, depend on Him. And He who is cool, calm, and collected, He who is above every situation will give you solutions, will give you breakthrough. He will come through for you and save the day and build you out. Are you trusting in Him? What would Jesus have done in your situation? He would have been cool, calm, and collected, and trusted that His Father would have helped Him. And His Father always did help Him. And God says that He wants to help you. Would you trust Him? Would you relinquish that burden that you are holding on to? The Bible says that, come to me. Jesus says that, come to me, all you are heavy laden, and I shall give you rest. Why don't you cast your burdens to Him? Why don't you give the problems to Him? Why don't you trust Him? Why don't you allow faith in Jesus Christ to confront your fear? Why don't you allow faith to confront that fear? And that fear will dissolve and disappear, because Jesus has power over every situation. I came to pray for you that God will give you the grace to release that problem to Him and see how He will give you a miracle. May God help you. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for your son. I pray for your daughter. May you help them. May you help them. Whatever situation they are going through, Father God, you are always cool, calm, and collected. You are always at rest with every situation. May you give them that same peace, that same quietness, that same attitude of joy and quietness and harmony in their lives. And may they begin to express cool, calm, collectedness in their lives. May they know that you are in control. I come against depression. I come against anxiety. I come against fear. I come against worry. I come against nervous breakdown. I come against disappointment and hopelessness. I release faith. I release boldness. I release courage into the body of Christ, even in Jesus' name. Father, come through and perform a miracle in their lives. In Jesus' name I pray. May we have testimonies. Let me know when you get your testimony, because testimonies are taking place. Let your expectations be in God, and He will give you a miracle. May God richly bless you. Confront your fear with faith in our Lord Jesus. Because whenever Jesus was confronted with a problem, He was always cool, calm, and collected. What moves you and I does not move the Holy Spirit. It does not move Jesus. Because the Holy Spirit is our comforter. The Holy Spirit is our helper. The Holy Spirit is our friend in need. In times of trouble, He will help you. He will build you out. He will make a way for you where there seems to be no way. Put your trust and your confidence in Jesus. God richly bless you. Bye.